All of you, welcome to the session. Today we are going to talk about impracticability of Carnot's engine. So let us see what are the impracticals about Carnot's engine. In Carnot's engine, the heat is to be taken and rejected strictly at a constant temperature, which is practically very difficult to achieve. In actual engine, the temperature of hot body progressively falls as it gives heat, and that of cold body rises as it receives the heat. The base of cylinder of the engine is assumed to be perfectly conducting and the other parts perfectly non-conducting. This is not again feasible. The engine has very slow working. It doesn't matter whatever be the efficiency of the engine. If it is slow working, it may be of no use in day-to-day life. It is perfectly reversible in its action. When the cycle is reversed, the working substance will take an amount Q2 of heat to energy from the sink and gives out an amount of Q1 of heat to the source. The engine thus acts as a refrigerator. These features cannot be actually realized. Hence, it is not possible to obtain a Carnot engine in practice. So these are the impracticabilities of Carnot's engine. So let us move on to another topic here. So second law of thermodynamics. We covered two laws till now. One is zeroth law of thermodynamics and another one is first law of thermodynamics. What we have done in first law? There we have given some amount of heat energy to the system, and a part of that heat energy can be used to increase the internal energy, and the rest of part of that heat energy is utilized to do work, right? So what happened in second law of thermodynamics? Let us see. A heat engine takes heat from source, converts a part into mechanical work, and the balance is rejected to the sink. As the engine absorbs more and more heat from the source, the temperature of the source continuously falls and after some time becomes as that of surroundings. Now, no heat flow is possible. In this case, the engine stops working. That is, no work can be obtained from engine. So, Kelvin's statement of second law. So, what Kelvin says, it is impossible for any device that operates on a cycle to receive heat from a single reservoir and produce net amount of work. So it is impossible to get a continuous supply of work from a body by cooling it to a temperature lower than that of its surroundings. So we know that the body which is having more temperature, so that the heat transfer takes place from more temperature system to lower temperature system, right? But here it is what happened. If it is impossible to get continuous supply of work from a body by cooling it to a temperature lower than that of its surroundings, right? That means what happened when the temperature of the body is lower than the surroundings temperature, so it is not possible to receive the heat energy from the bodies which possess lower temperatures, right? Next, so what are we called refrigerators? In nature, we know that heat flows from high temperature regions to low temperature regions. The reverse process, however, cannot occur by itself. So we know that heat transfer from high temperature regions to low temperature regions. But reverse process, is it generally possible to reverse? No, it is not possible to transfer heat from low temperature regions to high temperature regions. The transfer of heat from low temperature region to a high temperature region, one requires special device called refrigerators. Right, with the help of refrigerators only, we can transfer heat from low temperature region to a high temperature region. So let us see what classes According to Clausius, what is second law of thermodynamics? See there, it is impossible for a self-acting machine to transfer heat from a body at low temperature region to another body at high temperature region without help of external agency. It is very clear that without the help of external instrument, without the aid of external instrument, it is impossible to transfer heat from low temperature region to high temperature region. This statement of second law is based on working of refrigerator. In refrigerator, the transfer of heat takes place from a cold body to a hot body with the help of an external agency. No refrigerator is so far has been designed which can transfer heat from a cold body to a hot body without the help of external instruments, right? So where two laws are there, two thermodynamic second laws are there. One law is proposed by Kelvin and another law is proposed by Clausius. So (sighs)